cemetery in Sleepy Hollow, New York, conjures up frightening images.
Ichabod looked over his shoulder and saw, yes, that was a black shape following him closer and closer.
It could only be the fearsome headless horseman pursuing poor Ichabod Crane, as depicted in the 1949 Disney film, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. We must disclose that rumors persist that this place is still haunted. And among the spirits here is that of Washington Irving, the man who made the place famous by writing the legend, as guide Linda Ford explains.
He was a brilliant satirist, and I think if he were alive today, he'd be writing for SNL.
Yes, these brave souls dare to venture into the spooky world.
This became the home of Barnabas Collins, the vampire.
Of cemetery tourism.
Come in.
I just think they're wonderful places. They're full of history, and they're full of architecture. And
full of dead people.
They're full of dead people, but they don't mind.
If there's a chief tombstone tourist, it has to be photographer Doug Keister, who's visited hundreds of cemeteries and published 4 books.
We have Andrew Carnegie.
He says it's a great way to see how the rich and famous end up. Folks like steel manufacturer Andrew Carnegie.
He was one of the wealthiest men in America, and his monument, which is a Celtic cross, is actually quite simple.
Even simpler.
Immediately under us is a concrete vault that,
according to the cemetery's historian Jim Logan, is the virtually unmarked gravesite of Darling Leo, a Cocker Spaniel, interred in 1892 by a wealthy tobacco heiress who visited every day.
She would hire local school children to accompany her, and she paid on a sliding scale. The more tears they shed, the higher the wages.
Turns out you can learn a lot about human nature by visiting a cemetery.
This is bigger than a lot of people's homes.
Yes, yes. Well, it's the Helmsley Mausoleum, and it's smaller than their home.
No surprise that hotel magnate Leona Helmsley, notorious for her personal extravagance, would shell out millions for a tomb for herself, her beloved husband Harry, and her even more beloved Maltese, Trouble. But guess what? The Queen of Mean, as she was known, first built this mausoleum, now owned by others, at Woodlawn Cemetery in the Bronx.
In my position, I get to learn all their stories.
Historian Susan Olson says Leona was dead set on moving because she claimed her view here had been spoiled.
She brought a lawsuit against the cemetery?
Yes, she did.
Is that all over, or is that still going on?
I'm not allowed to talk about it.
Of course, going out in style is old hat here at Woodlawn. This replica of Leonardo da Vinci's tomb, constructed at the turn of the 20th century, houses Oliver Belmont of the Belmont Raceway and his wife Alva Vanderbilt Belmont.
What was the reason that they wanted to duplicate Da Vinci's tomb? Just because they could?
Yeah, just because they could.
And in a place where you can see the tombs of everyone from Miles Davis to F.W. Woolworth, and architecture styles from classic Egyptian to Gothic, complete with gargoyles, our favorite may just be this one, that Keister calls "What Were They Thinking" architecture. Eccentric patent medicine maker Clark Dunlop and his wife Eliza loved parrots, and not just on stained glass.
And if you turn around,
do I want to
turn around? Turn around in this little box.
A parrot skeleton!
That's a parrot.
Oh my gosh!
And that's the great thing about a cemetery. Might not be Night of the Living Dead.
Still in search of the head.
But you'll never be bored stiff.